Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. I know it's been a long while since my last upload, so in this series I'm going to provide you a roadmap based on what I learned from school and maybe expose you to a little bit of the wine science, wine chemistry, sensory science, so that you can build your wine knowledge of tasting or anything, feel a little bit more comfortable to ask questions during your next vineyard visit. Even just at the wine tasting party, you will feel a little bit more confident and comfortable to communicate wine. First of all, let me briefly and maybe brutally explain a little bit what's the difference between wine science, wine chemistry, and sensory science. Wine science encompasses the entire process of the wine production, from viticulture, enology, to the final product. This includes aspects of biology, chemistry, biotechnology, and microbiology. It focuses on understanding biological and chemical processes involved in grape growth, fermentation, and aging to improve wine quality and consistency. The scope includes research on grape variety, climate effects, soil science, and the impact of winemaking techniques. Wine chemistry, on the other hand, specifically focuses on wine's chemical composition, including acid, sugar, phenolic compounds, and aromatic compounds. It focuses on analyzing the chemical transformation during fermentation, aging, and storage conditions to understand how this process affects wine quality and sensory attributes. The scope involves understanding the chemical interactions between grape components, yeast, bacteria, and environmental factors to optimize wine production and authenticity. Sensory science, on the other hand, is about you. It might sound funny, but it actually involves the systematic evaluation of a product's characteristics through human senses, such as sight, sound, taste, touch, and smell. I mean, can you hear the wine? When it comes to wine, sensory science helps us understand how humans perceive wine aromas, flavors, and textures, and how this perception relates to the wine's chemical composition, which results from different viticultural practices and winemaking techniques. It helps winemakers to make informed decisions to deliver high-quality products, giving business owners insights to consumer preference. And for us wine lovers, sensory science, especially learning all the descriptors, where they're from, how they are formed, can help us express our senses through the right vocabularies. In short, understand a little bit of a wine science can help you ask questions like, what are the grape varieties planted in their vineyards? What disease problem they might have, because each variety has different problems. And what's the assemblage, like what's the blend in each bottle? Because each variety has its own characteristics. And at the tasting room, with the help of wine chemistry and sensory science, you can feel a little bit more comfortable and maybe have the better keywords to describe a glass of wine. Here's a table to review what we just learned. You can pause and screenshot it. This three discipline, wine science, it focused entirely on wine production process. The scope is covering viticulture and winemaking. The relevant words you will hear under this discipline are usually cépage, the so-called grape varieties, terroir, barrels, amphora, the clay. And the second discipline, which is the wine chemistry, is the chemical composition and transformation of a wine. Usually, it's under the scope of fermentation, vinification, aging, and chemical analysis. Some keywords related to wine chemistry could be pyrazine, terpene, geosmin, thiol, phenolic compounds, volatile acidity. And sensory science is the most common one because you hear them all the time at any wine tasting. It's about the human perception of wine attributes. It's really about this consumer preference and the sensory evaluation. Words that's related to this discipline are usually, you know, those floral, herbal, and fruity notes, stone fruits, bitterness, I can go on and on. Knowing a bit about the wine production process, such as the characteristic of different grape variety, it's kind of like human. We all grow up in different family with different way of education, so we kind of grow into different or similar type of people. Grapes are the same. Knowing a little bit of different characteristics of different grape varieties under different viticulture practices and the techniques of fermentation and aging, the chemical composition and transformation, and the human perception of wine attributes can help you remember aromatic descriptors better and make wine tasting a little bit more interesting. To me, the easiest way to remember how to describe a wine is also depending on the people who I'm sharing that bottle with. So gather your friends and family on a Friday night, playing some descriptor games, hosting some blind tasting, explore each other's senses through this lovely gathering. Now let's talk about the framework that will help you train your nose and strengthen the memory of a descriptor in your brain link the feeling and the words together so that you don't just blindly follow or memorize all the vocabularies from an aroma wheel or some blog post. Instead, you are going to intentionally look at those words, knowing how to identify them, knowing where they're coming from, and registering your brand properly. So this is a personal preference, or maybe it is because of a habit from the restaurant experience. Whenever I open a new bottle or get served a glass of wine, the first things I try to do is to find, to experience, to see, is there a sense of defects or not? As interesting as it is, if the defect is not overpowering, is not masking, or is not too obvious running towards your nose, usually other dominant aromas in primary or secondary will present itself. Especially in young wine, the primary aroma could be fruity and floral, or the secondary aroma such as the creamy, buttery notes, and the tertiary aroma. It really depends on the wine style. The spice and the vanilla will flow around. To untangle the mystery of wine aromas, let's dive into the wine defect and different levels of aromas: primary, secondary, and tertiary. Wine defects are the aromatic compounds that mask or alter the original or intended wine profile. They commonly appear due to winemaking errors, external contaminants, or simply undesirable in some contexts. Wine defects can transform a once enjoyable wine into something je ne sais quoi. Primary aromas, the so-called variety aromas or pre-fermentative aromas, I guess it's quite obvious what they are already. They are those fruity, herbal, fresh, floral from the grape variety. This aroma reflects the characteristic of different grape cultivar. The intensity of this characteristic is usually related to the climate, terroir, and the viticultural practices. The descriptor you will hear usually are the citrus, stone fruits, or the berry families. Secondary aromas, or fermentative aromas, are derived from the winemaking process, specifically fermentation. These aromas are direct substrate from yeast metabolism during alcoholic fermentation or malolactic fermentation. They added complexity to the wine. It's a creamy, buttery note sometimes you'll find in a Chardonnay. Tertiary aromas develop during aging and usually affects by the storage conditions, such as oak barrel or bottle aging. Notably, when the fermentation occurs in a wood vessel, the vanilla or coconut taste is actually coming from the contact with wood. Those notes is actually categorized as tertiary aroma instead of secondary. These aromas contribute to the wine's maturity and bouquets. The common descriptors are spice, leather, nutty, earthy, and tobacco. So now we know the critical classes of wine aromas: the defects, primary, secondary, tertiary aromas, and that's exactly how I structure this series. In the next episode, we will dive deeper into wine defects, what they are, how they are formed, and how to identify them. Don't forget to like and subscribe and click here. I will see you in the next episode.